Welcome back to once again another Napoleon Total War battle. So today we have a 3v3 on Salamanca province, and this was a replay sent in to me by Deadly for You, and he's going to be in command of the British. So let's take a look at his army, but before we do, the rules for this battle were no artillery, max 4 lights. So talking about that, let's go straight into his army. So in the front lines he has 4 rifles. Behind that looks like he has 4 foot guards. Further behind that, 4 fencibles, and then further behind that, you got some Highland foot. And then finally, in the forest, hidden are the 42nd and the light goons. So he's going to keep a couple of units here, hidden in the forest. And facing Deadly is going to be the Ottomans. So the Ottomans, they decided to group up, so they're all going to be the Ottomans. But for his allies, we have Prussia over here in the center. He's going to be controlling this town. And then finally, on the far right flank, we have Britain. That's going to be controlling the right flank. I previously did record this replay, but sadly, my microphone was not on. So I will go in depth as to what's happening, because I know exactly what's going to be happening as things start to progress. But just stay tuned, guys. This battle really, really gets very, very close. Not going to say how many units the team that won by, but it was an extremely close game. So let's get right into the action. So you see the Prussians are forming up. They're going to be taking up positions inside the town. Ottomans are also going to be pushing in as well, but they're taking their time doing so. And you see the Ottoman force has a pretty massive cavalry force of Delhi horsemen. You see some of them are going to be hidden. But one big issue both teams are going to be facing are these valleys. Now, whoever is going to be attacking is pretty much on the worst end, just because they're going to be fighting an uphill battle, and that is never fun for any army. So they're just going to have to keep that in mind. But great job here for Deadly, bringing those militia units. If they do have to assault, at least they will have a meat shield, to beat their front lines. So that is a great move there. You see he's going to be placing stakes and preventing any of those Ottoman cavalry from pushing up. Looks like his opponent did bring some cavalry. You see them on the far right flank, his far left. And they are mounted cavalry, so that means they can shoot from horseback. So he's really going to have to watch out for those guys and treat them like a line infantry unit. In the city, though, you can see the Ottomans are pushing up. And it looks like they're going to be taking this building as well. You can see the Prussians on the opposite end as to where the Ottomans are over here. On the far left flank from the Ottomans' point of view, they are also taking up defensive positions. But you can see they're kind of in the valley here. If Britain were to push up, they'd be at a great advantage here. So it doesn't look like he's going to be capitalizing there. It does have cavalry moving, but the British and, Deadly really have to think about using their cavalry effectively, just because Ottoman cav is just so deadly. There's not too many elite cavalry that the Ottomans possess. But they do have a really massive cav force. There's a couple of elite cavalry units here. The guard cavalry, very, very elite. Probably one of the best cav units in the game, if not the best. But Deadly's going to be, sticking back. I'm actually going to fast forward this battle just a little bit, because there's not too much action actually happening. Looks like there is a massive push here on the right flank for the British. Looks like they're going to be trying to overwhelm, the enemy with their lights. See, they're going to be pushing up their troops very shortly. Looks like there was a little minor engagement here with some Ottoman cavalry, but it looks like those lights did, pick them off. But here we go, guys. First engagement has started. The Prussian Fusilier is taking the first shots, but they're going to get shot back at by some Ottoman line infantry. So they're going to be falling back to their main line where those musketeers and foot guards hold. Inside the town, there's a little engagement here. And you see those Ottomans are pushing up into position now. It looks like we got some Ottoman cavalry in the background, and they look very unhappy. It looks like they're going to be trying to charge in. We will see what happens here. We got more cavalry now charging from, the hills. They're going to be charging straight into these musketeers. Let's see if these guys can form a score in time. And yes, they will. Great job here having a second line of reserve. These foot guards are going to do an excellent job of wiping you know, making sure these guys do die. But sadly, they do get charged into. But good news, there are Hussars in the back that will help counter that as well. But great job here from the Ottomans. They're actually going to be forming up their line infantry and pushing them up. And you see a lot of confusion is happening for these Prussians just because they're in square formation and they're unable to counter these line units that are forming up. So he's really going to have to get them out of square really quickly, or he's going to have to counter with cavalry, and that is what he's doing right now. So Ottomans decide to charge Cav. He's going to do the exact same back. So great job here. Looks like the Ottomans were unable to form a square. That's going to cause a lot of damage right there, bringing them down to red morale. You see those Janissaries also doing an alright job. They did take some losses, but they're currently in melee engagement. So right now, it's just who can throw more cavalry into the mix. It seems to be the victor. But great job here by Prussia. You know, forming square at the appropriate time and really trying to maximize that square. Over here, it looks like the Musketeers were not so all lucky. Looks like just one cavalry unit caused all this devastation. And just a great example of this. Those Musketeers are unable to get a single shot off while these Ottoman lines are engaging. So just the amount of confusion it is causing is just incredible. So even though if he does form a square, it's still going to really, really mess up, you know, his lines to counter those lines. But here we go again, another cavalry unit right now. It is very, very hard for these Musketeers to try and hold their ground against such cavalry forces. And these guys are extremely elite cavalry, so he really needs to form square. Will he do it, though, is the question. Over here on the right flank, though, Britain is really in the thick of things. Look at that cavalry charge, just throwing people back. Look at all those guys just lying down. So, not looking too great for Britain. It doesn't look like he's paying attention on the right flank whatsoever. But he does not have infantry support to help his Ottoman cavalry out. So it looks like these British will hold their ground just fine. Looks like the British lights are in a skirmish engagement. It looks like they're focusing their attention at the cavalry over here on the right flank. Probably a smart move because he really needs to break those guys quickly. And that is exactly what's happening. These Ottoman cavalry are breaking without any infantry support. So if the Ottomans were able to capitalize, but it looks like there was no, you know, infantry on the left flank. Ottoman infantry on the left flank to do anything, so I don't know if it was worth charging. I know those guys are very depleted, but still, I think he could have saved a couple cav units by having some infantry aid. But look at this, Ottomans doing what they do best, charging into melee with some Janissaries. Great job here. Foot guards in melee with the Janissaries, but they're going to be getting shot in the back by their own lights, so that is not good. You see the morale is very much dropping. And look at that, great example. These guys are going to lose a lot of morale. They should easily win this engagement, but seeing that they got shot in the back, they're going to lose a ton of guys. Over here, though, looks like they just ran short of numbers. You see morale's getting bad as well. We got some foot guard above the hill right now. They're going to be raining downhill from below, or from above. Those guys are going to break as well. We got the Royal Scots Grey in melee combat right now against those mounted cavalry units. We do have a Ottoman line infantry unit engaging some more foot. But the Ottomans are not doing so great in the town right now. These Prussians are really able to counter. I mean, I can't tell you how many units have been thrown in here. At least cavalry units have been charged into. And they're still holding strong. They have lost a lot of numbers, and you clearly see that with the foot guards running away. But, I mean, they're doing an amazing job right now in keeping control of this town. As for the center, though, center left, there is an engagement here, or the far left, excuse me. It looks like these Ottoman cav units are actually charging into the square. Allied foot unable to form a square, but they do have the stakes to save them there. Looks like they're going to be trying to run away. Look at that, shooting from horseback, causing a lot of damage here. Should probably stick in. Oh, wow, okay, so thought they broke, never mind. So he's going to keep pulling back, but these Ottoman cavalry causing a lot of damage to him. Over here, we have a melee engagement as well. Fencibles caught off guard. And they do end up breaking, so easy victory there for the Ottomans. But look at this. Deadly, really good teamwork right now. Sending over a couple Highland foot to make sure the Prussians do secure this right flank. The Musketeers are being forced back a little bit. but they are still somewhat holding their ground right now. You can see these Prussian Fusiliers engaging those Ottoman line of infantry as they cross the field. And another massive cavalry charge here. We've got some Delhi horsemen now charging through the town, and they're going to try and find their target over here. Let's see, they might actually be going for the general, and yes they are, so going for a cheeky charge right now. So, Ottoman player knows if he can get the general, the morale is going to drop drastically for the Prussians. Prussians seem to not care too much, not sending any troops to counter that cav unit. So, this bodyguard unit's all on his own right now, but look at this, we got some foot now. They're going to try and help aid that general. They might be out of range. I don't think so, though. Here they go. Now they're going to start aiding, but it is too late. And the Prussian general is dead, so huge drop in morale. You see the units are now starting to break. Another unit in red morale. And this is going to cause a pretty big issue for the British on the right flank, because you can kind of see these armies are kind of isolated from one another. But look at this. You can see the really hard flank by the British. They're slowly pushing up, but doing a fantastic job as they do so. You can see the battle started over here, and they've just been turning and turning and turning, trying to outflank the Ottomans. And seeing that the Ottomans don't have too much line of infantry, it's going to allow the British to really use their numbers and outflank the opponent, especially when they have limited cavalry left. So great job here, though. He's got some guard cavalry charging into those light infantry, unsupported too. There are some line infantry far back, but they're not going to be doing too much just because those trees are going to be interfering with the bullets. Looks like the British are going to be forced to pull back their attack right now. The cavalry unit's really being very annoying. They did lose a lot of guys, so that is not good as well. And you see these Ottomans are just pushing forward farther and farther. And they're pretty much at the Prussians' side of the town now. He does have a lot of reserves inside the town. And it looks like he's going to be pushing them up as well. Taking a look at Deadly's side of the battlefield, looks like the Ottomans are going to try and flank. Like I said, they're going to be fighting an uphill battle, so he's going to have to really think of something to try and overwhelm Deadly. Deadly, though, has a great positioning, and he still has these hidden units that he has not shown his enemy. Excuse me. So he might use those guys very, very shortly. But he does have a lot of reserves. The Ottoman player should probably push up a lot more units right now, just because he's assaulting, and he definitely needs those troops to help that engagement go well. But over here, it looks like Deadly's troops are going to be pushing up, helping these Prussians out and taking the front lines, while these Prussians sit back and re-energize because they are very, very tired from that engagement. So here goes the Highland Foot doing what they do best and having a nice line engagement with these Ottomans. Ottomans should not stand a chance. You can see one unit breaking right there. But look at this. We got some Safai cavalry now pushing in. We'll see what happens. Looks like they're going to be charging somewhere else now. Didn't cause Deadly to form square, so great job there not going for the bait. He's going to try to get another charge in on those Dragoons. Dragoons don't have the best skill against Safai cavalry, just because they are not meant for cav engagements, but they're doing alright. Especially when they have Safai cavalry and line infantry that they're fighting. But the British now have reformed their lines. That cavalry that charged those lights are now pretty much gone. I think they got shot down by these foot that are in the back. So they're going to once again start this engagement back up. Ottoman morale is getting very bad here, but as well as the Dragoons. They're going to be fighting some line infantry, and they do break as well. So those Dragoons do survive. Let's take a look back into the town. Looks like the Prussians are going to try to assault the left side of the city. We'll see. You got some foot guards here up against some regular line infantry. Very nice volley. But he still controls this building, and that's a huge importance for these Prussians. So seeing that Prussia is pretty much out of this game, they've used pretty much all their units. They're going to be sitting back in the town, but look at this. Deadly's going to bringing out his light dragoons out from hiding because he needs them now because he's getting overrun by these Ottomans. You can see a melee engagement happening right here. They're going to be charging into some foot. put Doomform square, so great job here getting some point-blank volleys in and destroying these guys. Looks like they're going to be charging downhill now into these fensible units, so we will see what happens here. I'm pretty sure these fensibles will be able to hold up against those Janissaries just because they are very tired, and that makes their morale and fighting a lot weaker. So great job here forming square at the appropriate time. Now we got some light dragoons charging down onto some of these mounted cavalry units that the Ottomans have to offer. And they're going to try and protect these rifles, these hussars are, or light dragoons, excuse me. He's going to try and pull his general out of there as well. But you just see this Ottoman push is just, they're sending a ton of troops in. Uphill charge though, so it's going to really slow them down, but what he really needs to do right now is really commit all his troops, because if this attack fails and he doesn't have any troops to support it, it's going to be disastrous for his flank. But as of now, it looks like the Ottomans are actually holding their ground with what numbers they have. It looks like they have equal numbers on the right flank, but this melee engagement can drastically change who will win this engagement. Over here though, the British are still kind of at a stalemate right now. They're going to have small light engagements, you can see from afar, getting occasional kills, so the rest of the lines are going to be resting up a little bit, but you can see he does, you know, have some pretty good numbers on the right flank, but so do the Ottomans, and they do have a general in the back, so they will have really good morale. But you see the Highland foot are starting to get drained. They've been fighting on this side, trying to help aid the Prussians. I mean, they're still doing a great job, but they're facing way too many guys. They should break very, very shortly. Plus, the Ottomans do have the hill advantage, as well as the forest. So, not looking good here for the Highland foot. And soon, these Prussian reserves are going to be, once again, the front line. And they are very low. Let's take a look on the left flank, though. Got more of a cav engagement now, charging into these rifles. That is not good. But look at this. Ottoman push is starting to die out now. You can see the morale is getting bad, and one by one, units are starting to break. We got a cavalry charge, actually, yeah, cavalry and melee charge here from some line of infantry. They're going to be charging into the lights. Lights are very isolated right now. They have no protection whatsoever from any other unit, so they can very well die here. Let's take a look back in the town. We can see an actual melee engagement happening right now. It looks like one of the Ottoman units managed to melee and charge into the building here. They're going to get caught up by some foot, but those guys are going to break. So very interesting move here. Somehow these Ottomans were able to push through the town and avoid these musketeers and actually get into the building. So they're going to be fighting some Prussian fusiliers. Ottoman player knows that those fusiliers will break if they are not supported. So it looks like he's going to try and push them in very shortly. But you can see once again another line unit that's going to be pushing in as well. So it's going to be a battle of who can throw more guys in the building will be the victor. If you throw enough guys in there, they're sure going to win the engagement. But look at this. Ottoman general charging his own unit in. Look at these guys run. They are out of here. They are wavering. Not looking good right now for this unit, and they should break very shortly. So once again, the British are isolated on this flank, but nothing too much that the British have to worry about. They do have quite, you know, equal numbers with the Ottomans. If not, they have more. But look at this, Janissaries charging into this foot. They're going to be in melee combat now. Janissaries are very tired, though, so it's going to cause a lot of bad morale for them. Looks like Deadly is going to be pulling back his lines now. He's going to try and reform. You can see he took some catastrophic losses as well in that assault. He still has some foot, but look at this. We got some Banshee Bazooks now coming in. They are the brother of the Janissaries, but a lot weaker. You can say they are the younger sibling of the Janissaries, but look at them coming in. They are winded, so they have some pretty good stamina now, but they are running uphill, and they're getting shot by some foot. Will these foot be able to break them before they make it to their lines? I am not too sure. I don't think so. Here he comes. Actually, hitting his own guys, General Staff. But he's trying to prevent those bazooks from getting into melee combat. But look at this. A lot of Ottoman lines still left. Great job here by the Ottomans. Really doing a great job in the assault, as well as keeping his numbers pretty high. Over here, Ottomans not looking too good at all. Their numbers are getting extremely low. They're actually getting flanked by the side right here. You can see Colstrian Guard shooting uphill. That one volley just killed a good 5-6 guys. So great job there. Very fast reload. So Ottomans are getting very desperate on this right flank. It looks like a clear victory for the British here. But things are not looking good on this left flank. The British do have numbers here, but if these Janissaries make it to melee combat, it is definitely over for them. See, they're trying to get their shots off right now. Captain firing as well. And it looks like he might have killed someone, not too sure. But they're going to be getting out of there as quickly as possible. You can see those Janissaries are going to be pushing up. He's going to be forming his lineup behind the hill. Janissaries going to be changing targets for those foot. They're charging uphill as well, but they have way too many numbers, and these foot are just going to get overwhelmed. Here they come, trying to take down some guys as they get into melee combat, but it is too late. These foot are now caught in melee combat. So pretty much the only strong side that Dudley has to offer now are these foot and the 42nd. These guys are pretty much the only line units that have some pretty good health. We got some foot over here in the general staff. So it looks like Dudley's going to be pulling back his army. He really needs the reinforcements from the other British player that has won his engagement. You see there's only one Ottoman unit left and they are very low. So he's really relying on his ally right now to come and aid him as he gets assaulted pretty heavily right now. See these Janissaries continuing their charge into these foot. Foot are pretty screwed by now and they do end up breaking. And look at this, the Ottomans have claimed that building. After fierce fighting inside the building, they do end up winning it. And look at all these guys die. These Prussians are just dying so rapidly right now. You got one guy trying to make a move outside the build to get outside the building, but does end up dying. So not good there. Ottomans do pretty much control the left flank right now. They are kind of pinched between two armies, but like I said before, Dudley has too small of an army to counter this massive force. So we're going to fast forward and see what happens. It's going to be basically a shifting game now, trying to get one, their armies in position to once again engage, and as well as regain stamina, because a lot of these guys are very tired from running across the battlefield. So we'll see what happens here. Just going to fast forward for now. You can see Dudley farming up his troops on the left flank. Just a couple units left, but they're going to be in some deep trouble as we have three Ottoman units pushing up now. But the 42nd are a very elite unit. And I have no doubt they will cause these Ottomans to suffer heavily. They do have a slight hill advantage here. But we will see what happens. So looks like the British are now going to be pushing across the town now, trying to push up on these Ottomans. And actually, it looks like the Ottomans are going to be taking the building for themselves right now. We will see what happens here. The British player really needs to take things smart here, or else he's really going to lose a lot of guys. Look at that. Looks like Dudley's general and one line unit did break. So it's down to the 42nd and some foot to hopefully try and save Dudley's army from disaster. But it's not looking good. You can see one unit, 95 guys, another unit, 101 guys, and the final unit with 58. Not to mention a huge cav force with 41 pushing in now. It looks like he's going to try and charge down the general. Maybe not. I'm not too sure there. But look at this. British are going to be trying to push up. We got a cavalry, actually Janissary charge pushing in now. Wonder where they're headed to. So we'll fast forward and see what happens here. Looks like an engagement here is happening. Looks like these foot are getting shot in the back. He notices that, so he's going to be falling back. But he did suffer a lot of losses. We got some light units. These light units are going to be engaging as well, but they're getting very, very close to some Ottomans. Wouldn't be surprised if these Ottomans get a nice volley off and break one of these units. Can't remember here. Let's see. Oh, he shredded that unit. These guys are done for, it seems. Yep, they are out of here. So with 12 guys left, they are heading back home. Over here, British actually holding very well right now. Actually forming square here. We got some the 42nd now pushing in. They're going to be getting into melee combat with these Ottoman line units, but they're going to be shooting in melee combat. going to be losing a lot of guys as they try to fight, and they do end up breaking. So Deadly has one more unit left in melee, and they're trying to counter that cav and line unit. So things are very, very close here. We have an engagement in the forest over here. Looks like those foot did get a little too close to those Ottoman lights. It did get shot up pretty heavily here. So we're going to have an engagement over here between some foot and some more line of infantry and Ottoman line. I thought these were, it was a memorial. But look at this. Looks like they're engaging that one unit there. It looks like those Ottomans should break. But looks like these guys are out of ammo, so they're going to be charging in. I don't think they're going to make it to melee combat with the numbers they have. And they're losing a lot of guys rapidly. Let's see if these British can get another volley off. Good shots as they try to push in, and they do break just before they're going to get into melee, so great job there. And they're going to fall back. Looks like the British did get into the building here, but they are only light infantry, so they should not last too long. Will they make it out? Oh no, they're going to get trapped here by some Ottomans. I'd be very surprised to see one of these guys get out of here alive. And they're just going to get destroyed. Oh, we got one guy here, and he's going to get choked to death. Not a fun way to go whatsoever, but look at this. We got some foot here now trying to counter these Janissaries. We got some foot over here as well. But very close game. You see Deadly is now out of this game. But things are very even right now. It's pretty much come down to a 1v1. The British victor on the right flank and the Ottoman victor on the left flank from the point of view of Deadly's army. Okay, so it looks like this line unit did break. And we do have the general's bodyguard here. Ottoman general's bodyguard charging into these Lightfoot. Lightfoot should not make it. Got some, once again, Bashi Bazooks trying to charge in. These guys are very, very quick on their feet. Look at them. Full speed, charging into these foot. Will the captain survive? Sword on sword. We will see. Looks like he's dodging a lot of bullets right now, and he's just going to be walking off. Oh. Will he kill him? Oh, he's just taking his time getting back to his unit. Running past people dying. Going back to his regiment. Very nice to see. Ooh, another unit. So now, wait, is Deadly? So Deadly is not out of this game yet, but he still has one foot unit. And that can be very helpful. We will see what happens. But he's going to be pulling them back, seeing that they are out of ammo. And things are going to settle down once again. We have these Janissaries winning that engagement. They're going to be falling back again as well. They still claim that building. And as we all know, taking over buildings and forts are an absolute pain. You know, you just suffer so many losses. So the British player and Deadly are going to have to think of something to try and overwhelm their opponent, because they still have pretty even numbers compared to the two. And it actually looks like the British do have the balance of power, but you know, on the battlefield it shows otherwise. So we got some Janissaries charging in now on the flanks. Their morale is getting very low. We'll see if they can beat back these King's German Legion, and they do not. They do kill a couple of these guys, but they do end up breaking. Look at this. We got the general now charging in, and they're going to get charged into. These foot are going to break very quickly. That was a great charge by the Ottomans. So it's basically like chess right now. They're trying to take out as many people as possible, or pieces as possible. You know, even though some of these units are pretty weak and are easy to, you know, take down, it's always good to do that if they are open, and you won't take many losses for that trade. So it looks like the Ottomans are going to pull back. You see they only have 5 units left, as to where the British have 6. But the British do have quite a lot of numbers in terms of line infantry. We still have some guys in the 95, 102, 42, 72. You know, against one Ottoman unit, 73, and another 72. So the majority of the Ottoman forces are generals' bodyguards. We do have one light unit. They're gonna get shot up pretty easily here. These Ottomans running out of ideas, so they're actually going to be charging in. Very interesting here. Without any support, he really needs to charge this general in, because these guys cannot form square. And look at this. Ottoman player still controls the building, and they're just getting shot in the back right now. Not a good idea at all. These British troops really need to assault that building. I know they're trying to take out this light unit, but they really need to get in there. So very close game indeed. He really needs to send this unit in here as quickly as possible. Look at this, getting cavalry charged. Will he form square? No, he will not. That is not good at all either. But the British still do have 6 units. Or actually, I think, yeah, 5 units. But they're going to be fighting this Ottoman general. You see him in the center of the square right now. It looks like they did form square. Don't know how they did that, but look at this. Will he make it out alive? We will see. He's actually going to be charging in. And look at this. He did die. So it looks like that one unit that formed square did manage to kill the general there. So huge morale shock for the Ottomans. But it looks like this foot guard is going to break. Their morale is getting very low. Might actually go up. So they do salvage that unit. And look at this. Other Ottoman general did die. So very bad right now. They're very bad morale right now for the Ottomans. Even though it may not show it, it's definitely going to influence how this game will... or what it will cause in the end. So we got another melee engagement. I'm going to fast forward here. These guys are going to be engaging inside the building right now. You see the British are slowly making their way up to the second floor. You see them doing that right now. Taking a look outside the building, we got this other Ottoman line unit that did break. So 2 units are left from the Ottomans. But other than that, he has nothing else to offer. We will see what happens here. I could have sworn there was 3 units. There might be. But as that melee engagement continues, I mean, look at this. Ottomans are fighting 3 units right now inside. And one British unit breaks. The other one is very, very low. Down to 22 guys. And these guys should break. And now it's down to a 1v1. 78 versus 42. Ottomans look like they are going to easily win this engagement. Morale's getting bad for Britain. It's very surprising. You see his generals right outside. But it looks like the Ottoman morale is still very, very high right now. I wonder if this general did die. He might be this guy right here. I'm actually pretty sure it's this guy. So very interesting to see how British morale is still not going for them. Even though they did kill the Ottoman general, they're still not having good morale whatsoever. So seeing that he's going to be losing the building, looks like he's going to be shifting in another unit here to hopefully try and beat back this Ottoman army or Ottoman unit inside the building. But taking a look inside, it's not looking too promising whatsoever. You see a lot of Ottomans are still occupying the entry point. And these British are all clustered up into one corner, taking their turn and then running back into their partners. They're still engaging inside. And look at this. Managed to break that one British unit. So now it's down to a 2v1. Very close engagement now. 57 men, 37, and a general's bodyguard. So we will see what happens right now. It is down to the wire, and look at this. This is Deadly's unit. He has managed to keep this unit alive, and he's going to try and counter this unit. But look at this. He's out of ammo, so he's on the run right now. He's exhausted, so he's going to have to use his teammate right now with the general's bodyguard to hopefully keep him alive because he is outnumbered. Looks like he did go in for a charge. Ottoman did form square. They're going to get shot at. They still have ammunition. Gonna keep pushing up as well. So these Ottomans still have the ability to form square, but if Deadly can get these guys to in the 40s, it would be a good you know, Izu charge that would allow the British to win. But it looks like the Ottomans are going to try and change their target over to the General Staff. General Staff's smart enough to pull back, knowing that he can easily outrun that any time. So Ottomans are still trying to push up. You see the British are now going to try and control the hills. Those are friendly stakes, so he doesn't have to worry about getting killed on a stake. But here we go, guys. So he's out of ammo, so he's going, Dedlick's going to have to think of some way to try and overcome, you know, having no ammo. So what he's going to do is he's going to use his terrain to his advantage. He's actually going to be hiding behind the hill, so the Ottomans will not be able to shoot him and kill him without, you know, getting very close to him. So that's exactly what he's going to be doing. And he really cannot take many losses at all. You see he's getting shot at right now, losing a couple guys, but manages to get behind the hill. The final engagement is about to begin. So forming square, Ottoman player knows exactly what to do. If he doesn't form square here and gets caught in melee, he can easily get charged by the British. So the British are going to wait for this engagement to begin. Hopefully, Dedlick's able to get these guys out of square, because right now his faith, or the Ottoman's faith, is holding the square. If the Ottoman does not form square and gets out of square, it's going to be a victory for the British. But if he can hold square and win that, it'll be a victory for him. So we will see what happens. We got the British cavalry now charging in. Look at this, he did manage to hold his square. Very, very bad square. That melee did cause a lot of damage, and look at this, getting out of formation now, unable to form square and break, so the morale was not able to hold up. I think the general did influence that win, and look at this, the British win with just their general staff. What a battle, everyone did phenomenal. Dedlick doing a great job, 1300 kills, Prussian player also doing a good job. 1,000 kills. It looks like the other British player, 1,700 kills. Great job there. Looks like Dedlick's opponent did a really good job as well, getting 1,800 kills, 1,400 kills, and then 900 kills. So everyone did a great job here. No one was slacking. Everyone was holding their own weight, and it turned out to be an excellent game. So great matchmaking here. Looks like the foot did a good job, 158 kills, but they did suffer a lot of losses. 42nd doing a decent job, but they did go negative. That's probably because he kept them in reserves and wasn't able to use them to their maximum potential. So anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this video. I think this is going to be out on Christmas Day, so if it is and you're watching it then, Merry Christmas. Hope you guys have a great day and spend some quality time with your family and friends. So that is pretty much it. I do have a couple things in the making that are going to be really, really cool. I think you guys are really going to enjoy it, but it's going to be a little mod with a couple YouTubers and I, and we're going to get something together. So a little heads up, so if you see me playing with any guys that you might know that are pretty popular in the, you know, Total War community, you guys are going to see quite the battle. So I'm not going to spoil it right now, but just keep a heads up for that. Something good is about to happen. So anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will see you guys later.